Growing up with strict parents, PG-13 rated movies were off limits until I turned 13. But in the summer of 2018, I watched my first ever PG-13 movie, Avengers: Infinity War, in which I saw Iron Man's iconic suit up for the first time, and I thought my life was changed. As I watched the particles engulf Tony Stark's body like some sort of metallic fluid, forming a mesmerizing display that rapidly and autonomously converts to create the universally known red and gold suit, Iron Man exclaimed, "It's nanotech. You like it?" to Bruce Banner, who seemed to be more wonderstruck than I was. And I've always been so intrigued by those typical sci-fi terms like quantum physics, the multiverse, cloning, and nanotechnology. And as I grew older, my curiosity only deepened. As I was loosely researching nanotech for an introductory level engineering course, I found myself in disbelief about how realistic this technology actually was. And despite the fact that Iron Man is a fictional character, the technological advancements depicted in his suit aren't as closely related to fiction as we think. And I firmly believe that mastering nanotechnology has the potential to rank among humanity's greatest achievements, alongside the creation of the modern computer and the internet. So what is nanotechnology? Let's break it down. The word nano is a prefix, meaning a billionth part of. So a nanometer is a billionth of a meter. To put that into perspective, take one of the hairs on your head. The thickness of human hair is about 100 to 180 micrometers. Now take that same hair and divide the width by 100,000. That's about 1 nanometer. Nanotechnology revolves around the manipulation and controlling of elements at the nanoscale, enabling scientists to work at the molecular and atomic levels. And this is really similar to chemical engineering in a fashion as it relates to the controlling of elements. This extreme precision allows for the creation of incredibly small devices, like Ant-Man's suit. But more importantly, this accuracy allows for inventions ranging from medicine to electronics. And believe it or not, this technology has already been implemented into everyday lives, in items like sunscreen, waterproof clothing, and adhesives. Now, diving deeper, nanotech holds vast potential in the field of construction and architecture. A quick history lesson. In 1991, Japanese physicist and inventor Sumio Ijima created the theory of carbon nanotubes. With a PhD in physics from the University of Tokyo, Ijima's pivotal paper, Helical Microtubules of Graphitic Carbon, published by Nature, marked a significant moment in science. His pioneering work unveiled the synthesis and observation of carbon nanotubes, which are cylindrical structures with extraordinary mechanical, thermal, and electrical properties. With exceptional tensile strength several times greater than steel, carbon nanotubes reinforce materials, preventing deformation under stretching forces. Their elastic and lightweight nature makes them ideal for enhancing composites, particularly in industries like aerospace, automotive, and superhero suits. And already, companies like NASA are using this nanotechnology in their aircraft as it provides a lightweight alternative to traditional copper coaxial cables, reducing the cable weight to almost 10% of copper. This significant weight reduction allows for greater payloads and contributes to lower fuel cost missions. This statement actually suggests that saving a pound in space vehicles can be valued at over $40,000, emphasizing the economic benefits of adopting carbon nanotubes in aircraft. Now, another field that nanotechnology shines in is in the field of medicine. Nanoparticles can be engineered to deliver drugs to targeted cells, minimizing side effects and increasing efficiency. This technology was actually implemented into the Pfizer COVID vaccines. So, an interesting fact. Out of all the COVID vaccines, Pfizer was the most effective. How it works is COVID-19 mRNA vaccines have specifically engineered lipid nanoparticles, which are nanoparticles encased by a layer of fat. These nanoparticles act as tiny bodyguards for the vaccine's genetic instructions, making sure they reach their destination safely, like chauffeurs. Now, imagine the genetic instructions as a secret message that needs to get to a specific location inside of your cells without being damaged. The lipid nanoparticles shield this message from any threats in the body, ensuring it is arrived intact. And this was especially important in the COVID vaccines due to the spike proteins that COVID introduces. So the word corona means crown, and the reason why coronavirus is called this is due to the crown-like structures on the surface of COVID particles. These structures are called spike proteins, and their shape makes it ideal for penetrating vaccines. However, thanks to the help of these lipid nanoparticles, a layer of fat is introduced to the vaccine, further preventing the thorns of COVID from damaging you. Thanks to lipid nanoparticles, the COVID vaccines have been incredibly impactful. The success rate almost 95% in trials and reported to have the least amount of side effects. Their exceptional performance have earned them emergency approval, marking a huge achievement in using nanotechnology to combat global health challenges like the COVID-19 pandemic. Another medical concern that has affected millions of lives is cancer. Cancer is a complex challenge due to its diverse nature and resistance to treatments. Late detection and limited understanding only add to the difficulties. Despite this, nanotechnology emerges as a hopeful solution, aiding both early diagnosis and treatment in the war against cancer. So picture nanoparticles as tiny spies, helping to detect cancer early. Engineered for precise imaging, they accumulate in cancerous tissues, standing out with healthy cells. Nanosensors, which are part of this innovation, swiftly detect specific cancer biomarkers by binding to unique cancer-related cells, and they can trigger a measurable response, like changes in conductivity, letting health professionals quickly detect cancerous cells. This fusion of nanotech and diagnostics holds vast potential, revolutionizing cancer treatments by identifying tumors more accurately, and embracing this innovation can lead us closer to a future without cancer. Now, venturing beyond medicine, nanotech has become a superhero in fighting climate change in terms of the fossil fuel arena. Nanoporous materials are particles with tiny holes on them, offering a larger surface area and customizable properties. These nanoporous materials can capture carbon dioxide directly from the air, and catalysts can transform it into valuable fuels, presenting an alternative solution from a dependence on fossil fuels. Efficiency also takes center stage as nanoparticles optimize combustion processes. Tiny particles, often made of metals like platinum or cerium oxide, act as catalysts, accelerating the breakdown of fuel molecules. By providing reactive sites, these particles can lower the activation energy needed for combustion, making the process way more efficient. And this catalytic boost has two key benefits. Firstly, it ensures a more thorough combustion, reducing the formation of harmful emissions like carbon monoxide. And secondly, it allows combustion to happen at lower temperatures, which is crucial for the longevity and efficiency of engines. And this isn't just theoretical talk. Already, industry leaders like Siemens Energy and Tesla are using this nanotechnology in their gas turbines and electric vehicle batteries. In the energy sector, nanotech is more than just a buzzword. It's a catalyst for revolution, promising a safer, sustainable, cost-effective, and efficient energy solution. So, in essence, although I just briefly touched on the aspects of nanotechnology in medicine, materials, and energy, nanotech holds endless potential in many other fields, like biotech, environmental remediation, water purification, robotics, and so much more. And if the human race were to ever come across the solution to those typical sci-fi breakaways like time travel or cloning, the cure to cancer, or Iron Man's Mark 42, we'd be through nanotechnology. So instead of burying this niche treasure in a box, we should strive to embrace the remarkable possibilities that nanotechnology offers. Adopting a realistic understanding of its capabilities can lead us to huge breakthroughs, significantly enhancing our lives, and bringing us closer to a world filled with red and gold suits. So that's nanotech. You like it?